Myself, Dr. Aparna Singh, Assistant Professor, Department of Kriya Sharir, Faculty of Ayurveda, Institute of Medical Sciences, BHU. Today, I will talk on a topic, Dhatu Sarata. We'll deal with the scientific approach towards the assessment of Dhatu Sarata in Ayurveda. The assessment of Dhatu Sarata in Ayurveda is given its prime importance because it is considered again under the heading of tenfold examination of the patients as Dashvid Pariksha. In Charak Vimanathan 8th chapter, Acharya Charak has specifically mentioned the importance of examination of patient in which Dashvid Pariksha has been told, among which it holds the position as Prakriti, Vikriti and Sar, third position, while assessing or rather examining the patient. For assessment of Bal in of an individual, Sar Pariksha is important. From starting point of view, it has been told that Bal Man Vishesh Gyanarth Sar Pariksha has been told for assessing the Bal of Purush, Sar Pariksha is done. In Shabdakalp Dhrum, it has been told that Shriyate Sthiri Bhavate Yatra Tat Sara, that is, the things which become stable is called Sara. Apart from giving Bal, it also provides stability to the individual or to the body or rather the Dhatus. And it is also told as it is the Vishuddh Roop of Dhatu. In Chakrapani, Charak Vimanasthan 8th chapter, is expert comment has been told that Vishuddhatar Dhatu Rachate Sara. It is the essence of Dhatu, which signifies the supreme quality of Dhatu and the super functional aspect is defined as Sara. That is, Dhatu Sar is important because while providing stability to the Dhatu, as well as it is the essence of all the Dhatus, or rather the supreme quality of the Dhatus, defining the structural and the functional entities of the Dhatus. It deals with the physical and psychological characteristics of an individual, which prove to be helpful in deciding the strength of a person. It has been told that merely looking to a person, we cannot assess the power or the strength of an individual. In Charak Vimanasthan 8 chapter, Acharya Charak has said that Katham tu Sharir Matra Darshan Dev Bishang Upachit Balvan Yukta. Means, just merely looking at a person, we cannot assess the inherent power. We cannot assess just by seeing the bulk and size of the body, but we have to assess the inherent power of the person. This could only be done by doing the SAR examination. Hence, the qualities of the tissue is analyzed by SAR Pariksha. It serves as an important diagnostic tool and is one among the 10 types of the method of examination under the Dashvid Pariksha, as we have earlier discussed, that it holds the third position after Prakriti, Vikriti, then Sar. The importance of Sar Pariksha is told by Acharya Charak, that is, it is important for the assessment of Bal of the patient. Bal is defined as the biological strength or power of resistance against the disease. It can be related with the immunity of the individual. According to the predominance of particular dhatu, the number of dhatu sarata present in the body of an individual will be directly proportional to the power of resistance of the individual. Hence, we can say that sarvasar individuals have higher resistance in comparison to madhyam sar or asar individual. We'll discuss later, after discussing the all ashtavidh sar, we'll see the features that Acharya Charak has told in Sarvasara Purusha Lakshana. It can also be recognized that the person of particular sar will have more resistance against the disease produced by the particular dhatu. In an evidence given by Acharya Kashyap, it has also been thought that the individual having the particular sar resist more against the disease of the particular dhatu and the sattva. According to him, the twaksar children have disease free from twak, and their skin is capable of rapid healing of the wounds, according to Kashyap Samhita. Types of sar in Ayurveda, Ashtaveda sar is mentioned. The individuals on the basis of sara have been classified into various categories depending upon the predominance of particular dhatu in the body except the sattva sara. The sequence of different sara will be enumerated or will be discussed accordingly. Ashtavidha sara, ras, rakta, mansa, med, asthi, majja, shukra and the sattva sara. So Acharya has discussed the physical as well as the psychological characteristics of an individual for providing the stress. He has not only dealt with the physical characteristic, but also the psychological characteristics were also noted. We'll come up with the differentiating features of the Ashtavidha Sara for better understanding. First, we will start with the Twak Sara. The characteristics told by different Acharyas. In Twak Chara, Acharya Charak has mentioned that the skin of an individual is the appearance of the skin is snigdha slakshan mridu prasanna sukshma alpa gambhira sukumara loma sa prabheva satvak sarana. That is, the skin, they appear as unctuous, smooth, soft, clear and lustrous. Rather, the hairs, they appear as fine, deep rooted, soft and delicate. Acharya Charak has dealt with the physical and psychological. Both characteristics has been told by Acharya Charak. In psychological features, he has talked about that the persons with Twaksar, they are endowed with happiness, good fortune, prosperity, enjoyment, intellect, knowledge, health, good health and enthusiasm and longevity. In that he has told in the reference the shloka in Vimant Sthan 8, Sukh, Saubhagya, Aishwarya, Upabhog, Buddhi, Vidya, Arogya, Prahasya, Ayushya, Cha, Ashti. Means he has clearly demarcated the physical characteristics as well as the psychological features of an individual having the Twaksara. Rather, Acharya Shushrut has given a very short differentiating features of Twaksara. Mainly dealing with the physical characteristics of the individual. He has told that the Twaksar individual will have Suprasanna, Mridu, Twak, Roma, Twaksar, Vipadityasham. That is, they have a soft, clear hairs and skin and they are knowledgeable. They are endowed with a good knowledge. Whereas Acharya Kashyap, he has said that the Twaksar individual, their skin will be lustrous, lustrous complexion, and they are free from any skin diseases, and the rapid wound healing features would be present in the Twaksar individual. Whereas in Brihat Samhita, he has said, incorporated the view of all the Acharyas rather, that the skin is unctuous, soft and thin, endowed with wealth, good fortune, knowledge and learning. A very sharp demarcating features have been mentioned between the different saras. So we will see that here in Twaksar, the skin is lustrous, smooth, unctuous. Next, we go to Raktasar. Raktasar individual, as per Acharya Charak, he has told, कर्ण अक्षी मुख जीवा नासा ओष्ट पाणी पाद तल नख ललाट मेहन स्निग्ध रक्त वर्ण दीज ऑल आर स्निग्ध अनक्टुअस एंड रेड कलर श्रीमद भ्राजी चश्रु रक्त सारणम दैट इज द ईयर आई फेस टंग नोज लिप्स पाम सोल nail, forehead, and genitals. They are unctuous, red color, beautiful, and dazzling appearance. And the psychological features were told as Sukh Uddatam, Medham, Manasutam, Saukumarya, Anatibal, Aklesh, Asahishnu, Ushna Asahishnu, Cha Ashti. That is, they are Sukh, happy, happiness. Sharp intellect, they are having the sharp intellect. Whereas in Tvaksarya said they are knowledgeable, but the Raktas are having the sharp intellect power. They are enthusiastic, tenderness, moderate strength. The power or the stamina of the Raktasar individual is having, they are having a moderate strength. Lack of endurance, they cannot tolerate the klesh even in a small amount, and they are intolerant to heat. Ushna Asahishnu. So these are the features that are told by Acharya Charak, whereas Acharya Shushrut has said the features of a Raktasar individual as Snigdh Tamra Nakh Nayan Talu Jiva Osht Pani Pad Talan. The nails, eyes, palate, tongue, limbs, and palm and sole, they are Snigdh Tamra, that is unctuous and coppery red. Whereas in the Tvaksar we have said that is they are lustrous and unctuous, and here we can see the clear demarcating features of the Tvaksar individual as well as the Raktasar individual, as they are having the skin as unctuous and coppery red. Brihat Sanhita has incorporated the view as the Raktasar individuals are red colored palate, lips, gums, tongue, palpebral conjunctiva, anus, hands and legs. Mansasar. Next, Mansar individual. The features of Mansar individuals are very clear, stated by both the Acharyas. As per Acharya Charak, he has told that Shankh Lalat, Krikatika, Akchi, Gand, Hanu, Griva, Skanda, Udar, Kaksh, Vaksh, Pani, Pad, Sandeya, Sthir, Kuru, Shubh, Manso, Pachata, Mansara. That is, the temporal region, forehead, nape, eyes, ear, jaws, neck, shoulders, abdomen, axilla, chest, joint of upper and lower limbs, they are firm, covered with heavy, good looking and beautiful muscles. This is the physical characteristics of the Mansar individual. The psychological features has been told that these individuals of Mansar, they are having Chama, Dhriti, Alalya, Vittam, Vidya, Sukh, Ajav, Arogya, Bal, Ayushcha, Dirga, Cha, Ashthe. That is forgiveness, restraint, that is the patience, lack of greed, wealth, knowledge, happiness, simplicity, health, strength and longevity. These are the psychological features. That is, those the Mansar individual that those are endowed with, these features are considered it Mansar. Whereas Acharya Shushrut has told a very clear cut demarcation of the Mansar individual as Achitragatram Gunasti Sandhi. That is, the compactness of the body of the Mansar individual has been told by Acharya Shushrut. That is, lack of depression in the body. They have a well compact body, well developed muscles covering the joints and the bone. This is the Mansar individual. Whereas in Brihat Samhita, they have told the Mansar individual had well developed, beautiful body, endowed with intelligence and wealth. So we see the demarcating features of the Tvaksar, Raktasar, and the Mansar. The compactness of the body, the structural appearance of the muscles. On specific regions has been told by Acharya Charak, on temporal region, forehead, nape, eyes, they all in these areas, the muscles are intact, formed, covered heavily with good looking appearance, and आचार्य सुश्रुत हैज टोल्ड द कॉम्पैक्टनेस ऑफ द एंड वेल डेवलप्ड मसल्स इन मांसाहार इंडिविजुअल्स. सो वी कैन सी द क्लियर कट डिमार्केशनिंग फीचर्स ऑफ द मांसाहार इंडिविजुअल एज पर आचार्य चरक एंड सुश्रुत. नेक्स्ट इज मेदसार. मेदसार इंडिविजुअल्स आर हैविंग वर्ण स्वर नेत्र केशलोम नख दंत ओष्ठ मूत्र पुरीशेषु विशेष स्नेहो मेदसारणम. दैट इज द कॉम्प्लेक्शन वाइज आईज हेयर टीथ लिप्स यूरिन एंड फीसिस आर अनएक्टिवस एंड द साइकोलॉजिकल फीचर्स आर मेंशन्ड एज ससारता विद ऐश्वर्य सुखभोग्य उखभोर्य प्रदान आजव सुकुमारोपचारित च अष्टे. दैट इज दे आर इंडोर्ड विद वेल्थ prosperity, happiness, enjoyment, charity, simplicity, and delicacies and dealings. Acharya Sushrut has mentioned the features of Medasar individual as Snigdha Mutra Svedaswaram Vrihat Sharira Ayas Asahishnu Medasa. That is, they are having unctuous urine, sweat, a mellow voice. That is Snigdh Mutra Svedaswaram, a mellow voice, mighty body, and lack of exercise tolerance. They are intolerant to exercise. Having a Vrihat Sharir, mighty body, and Ayas Asahishnu, that is lack of exercise tolerance. So these are the features of Medasar individuals. In Brihat Samhita, has been told that the Medasar individuals are having beautiful in appearance, endowed with wealth and progeny. Next is the Asthisar. Asthisar individual, as per Acharya Charak, are having prominent features like Pashani, Gulf, Janu, Aratni, Jadru, Chibuk, Shira, Parva, Sthula, स्थूलस्थि नखदंत च अस्थिसार ते मह उत्साह क्रियावंत क्लेश सहा सार स्थिर शरीर भवंत्य आयुष्मंतश्च. दैट इज सम पार्ट स्पेसिफिकली दे हैव मेंशन द सम बोनी प्रोमिनेंस ऑफ द अस्थिसार इंडिविजुअल. दैट इज द हील्स एंकल्स नीज एल्बो कॉलर बोन चिन्स head and joints, they are prominent and the bones, nails and teeth are large. Parvasthula, sthulasthi, nakhdanta cha asthisara, the bones, nails and teeth are large. The asthisara individual have a prominent skeletal features. Some bones are prominent. Typical areas have been enlightened, brought into focus, like the heels, ankle, knee, elbow, collarbone, chin, head, and joints. They are prominent of the asthisar individuals, whereas the bones, nails, and teeth are comparatively large. Now, dealing with the psychological features, mahotsaha. उत्साहवान, वेरी मच एंथुसियास्टिक, क्रियावंत, कैपेबल ऑफ फेसिंग, क्रियावंत मींस दे आर वेरी एक्टिव एंड क्लेशसाह, कैपेबल ऑफ फेसिंग डिफिकल्टी एंड आयुष्मंतश्च, लॉन्गिटिविटी ऑफ लाइफ. द पीपल दोज हु आर एंडोर्ड विद दीज साइकोलॉजिकल फीचर्स आर टर्म्ड एज अस्थिसार इंडिविजुअल. दैट इज दे आर वेरी एंथुसियास्टिक, वेरी एक्टिव and capable of facing any sort of difficulties. Whereas Acharya Sushrut has mentioned a very nice description of Asthisar individual, that the person having Mahasiraskanda, Dridhdanta, Hanuasti, Nakhastibi, that is the individual that possesses large head, that is head in the term of skull. He has told the individual who possesses large skull and shoulders, Mahasira Skanda. Skanda means shoulder, with स्ट्रॉन्ग टीथ जॉज बोन्स एंड नेल्स, दृढ़ दंत हनुवास्थी नख. दोज इंडिविजुअल हुज दो हु पोजेस अ लार्ज हेड एंड शोल्डर्स एज वेल एज द टीथ जॉज बोन्स एंड नेल्स आर स्ट्रॉन्ग कंपेटेबली टू अदर, दोज आर टर्म्ड एज अस्थिसार इंडिविजुअल. आचार्य शिशुत हैज टोल्ड टिपिकली अपॉन द फिजिकल अपियरेंस ऑफ एन इंडिविजुअल ओनली इनकॉर्पोरेटेड द पॉइंट एज महाशिरस्कंद दृढ़दंत हनुवस्थी नख. बृहद संहिता ही हैज ऑल्सो इनकॉर्पोरेटेड द व्यू ऑफ बोथ आचार्य लाइक थिक बोन्स फर्म इरेक्ट एंड अपराइट फीचर्स इंडोर्ड विद ब्यूटी एंड स्ट्रेंथ. नेक्स्ट इज मज्जासार. मज्जासार इंडिविजुअल एज पर आचार्य चरक टोल्ड एज मृदु अंग बलवंत स्निग्ध वर्ण स्वर स्थूल दीर्घ वृत्त संध्यश्च. मज्जासार ते दीर्घ आयुष बलवंत श्रुतवित विज्ञान अपत्य समान भवंती. दैट इज मज्जासार इंडिविजुअल, दैट इज द सॉफ्टनेस ऑफ द ऑर्गन्स स्ट्रेंथ एंड अनेक्टसनेस इन कॉम्प्लेक्शन एंड वॉइस इज प्रेजेंट इन मज्जासार इंडिविजुअल, दैट इज स्निग्ध वर्ण स्वर मृदु अंग सॉफ्टनेस ऑफ ऑर्गन्स एंड स्ट्रेंथ बलवंत स्निग्ध वर्ण स्वर. द वर्ण एंड स्वर दैट इज द कॉम्प्लेक्शन एंड द वॉइस इज अनेक्टस. रादर In next point, he has told the appearance of the joints of the Majjhasara individuals. They are sthula dirgha vritta sandhyascha. That is, they are prominent and rounded. Whereas in Asthisara, we have said they are dridh danta hanvasti. Strength, the power of the Asthisara is being that they are more impacted. Whereas the appearance in Majjhasara individual, the joints are stated that they are prominent, long and rounded. Whereas the psychological features is told as they are endowed with longevity of life, good physical stamina, learner, they are a very good learner, endowed with wealth, knowledge, progeny and they command or whether they had a good social dignity and respect in a society. Shrutvit Vigyan, they are a good learner and have a very good knowledge person and endowed with good physical stamina. So, Majjhasara individual has been talked in both aspect, physical as well as the psychological features. We can clearly demarcate it from the Asthisara individual, that there the appearance of the bones, or rather the strength of the bones, they have told, and here the joints, they have talked about the joints, that they are prominent, long and rounded. Sthula dirgha vritta sandhyascha. In Shushu Samhita, they have been told akrish uttam balam snigdha gambhir swaram saubhagyopan mahanetrascha. That is, the Majjhasara individuals, the persons are not emaciated, they are inactuous, deep voice, mahanetraj, big eyes and endowed with all good fortunes. In total, very much appreciation of Majjhasara individual has been done by Bodhacharyas in context of physical as well as the psychological aspect. Akrish Uttamalam, they are not emaciated. The persons are not emaciated. They have a very good strength of the body. And Gambhir Swaram, they have a deep voice. And Mahanetra. Mahanetrascha, that is the big eye. So see, these are the clear-cut demarcation what we are having or studying of the Majjhasara individual from the rest of the Sara. Each Sara is having a specific physical and psychological कैरेक्टरिस्टिक दैट मेक दैट गिव्स इट द डिफरेंशिएटिंग फीचर फ्रॉम द अदर. सो वाइल एग्जामिनेशन ऑफ अ पेशेंट वी कैन कीप दीज पॉइंट्स इन माइंड एंड डू अवर दशवित परीक्षा और रादर द सार परीक्षा ऑफ द पेशेंट. वृहत्तमित इन दिस दे हैव टोल्ड दैट द मध्यसार इंडिविजुअल्स आर ब्यूटिफुल अपेयरेंस एंड पोजेसेस वेल्थ एंड प्रोजेनी. नेक्स्ट इज द शुक्राचार्य इंडिविजुअल्स एज पर आचार्य चरक इज बीन टोल्ड दैट सौम्या सौम प्रेक्षण क्षीर पूर्ण लोचना इव प्रहर्ष बहुला स्निग्ध वृत्त सार संसंहत शिखर दशन प्रसन्न स्निग्ध वर्ण स्वरा राज उष्णु महास्विच शुक्रसार. दैट इज द पर्सन दैट आर इंडोर्ड विद द शुक्रसार लक्षण दे आर चार्मिंग पर्सन दैट इज सौम्य प्रेक्षण हैविंग द सौम्य गुण बिकॉज ऑफ द सौम्य प्रॉपर्टी दे आर सौम्य प्रेक्षण चार्मिंग पर्सन आईज एज ए फिल्ड विद मिल्क एंड इमेंसली एक्सहेलरेटेड क्षीर पूर्ण लोचने. It has been told that they are having a luster, a bright look of the appearance of the Shukrashar individual. Prahasha Bahula. Whereas the teeth of the Shukrashar, they are unctuous, rounded, firm, even and compact. Having pleasant and unctuous complexion and voice brilliant, having prominent buttocks. Mahaswicha, prominent buttocks. Here they have talked about the luster of the Shukrasar individuals. They are brilliant. Well, their voice is brilliant. That is very soothing voice they are having. And whereas the complexion is also very shiny of the Shukrasar individual. Whereas in Shushu Samhita, it has been told that Snik Sanghat Shvetasti Dantanakham Bahul Kam Prajam Shukrin. That is, the individual are having unctuous and well-built body, white bones, teeth, nails, and abundant semen. These persons are endowed with excessive sexual desire and progeny. In Vihat Samhita, is described as they have abundant and thick semen, endowed with fortune, good fortune and intelligence and beauty. These are the seven saras that have dealt with both the physical as well as the psychological characteristics. Whereas the last sara is the sattva sara. Here Acharya Charak has mentioned chiefly the psychological features of the sattva sara individual. The sattvasar individual, they are endowed with features like smritivanto, bhaktivanta, kritagya, pragya, shuchya, mahotsaha, daksha, dhira, samarvikranta, adhinasta, tyaktvishada, sattvasthitagatya, gambhir buddhicheshta, kalyan abhinivesha, sattvasara. That is, they are endowed with memory, smritivanta, devotion, bhaktimanta, kritagya. They are grateful, good learners, courageous, skillful, resolute, fighting in battles with powerless and free from anxiety. Tyakta vishada, serious intellect and activities and engage in various acts. Kalyana abhinivesha, they are always engaged in a good acts. Whereas Acharya Shushrut has described as the features of Sattvasara individual as Smriti Bhakti Pragya Shaurya Shaucha Upeta Kalyana Abhinivesha Sattvasaram Vidyat. That is, the individual with Sattvasara are endowed with good memory, they are devotional, intelligent, they are very clean, cleanliness loving person, endowed with valor, bravery, and good thoughts, benevolent thoughts, and in their thoughts and action, kalyan abhiniveshacha. So these are the differentiating features of the Ashtavidhasara as per the acharyas in Ayurvedic literature. Next, we see that not very much work has been done for assessment of SAR in recent work. Yet, an attempt has been made for the assessment of Dhatu SAR in some researches. So, some of the studies I have got where specific SAR has been studied, but yet much work has to be done or much work has to be needed for assessing or rather for making the assessment of Sarata in Ayurveda, because it is very important entity for assessing the individual both in a healthy and a disease state before we decide the treatment protocol. So Sartha assessment of Sartha has been undertaken by in some research studies that I will discuss just now. In short, a study done by Talwarekar et al. 2017. In this, he has seen the Sattva Sartha of the cancer patient. The patient, they are suffering with breast cancer, typically the females. In this, he has studied the Sattva Sartha of the patient. He has dealt while analyzing that Ayurveda has a holistic approach while dealing with the psychosomatic approach for the maintenance of health and cure of the diseases. In this, he has seen the Pravar Sara and the Asar of an individual. 60 patients were taken, 30 to 70 years from cancer hospital in Nagpur. The details will be available. And the Sattva Sartha was done by Sattva Sara Proforma provided by MUHS Nasik. Examination was done before starting the treatment and repeated investigation was done after three successive chemotherapies. And the 14 attributes of the Dhatu Sartha were typically the Sattva Sartha were assessed for the assessment of Sattva. He has seen that the Pravar Sattva Sara person were believed to bear any kind of physical and psychological stress. The treatment of breast cancer in females needs psychosomatic approach for treatment, as we all agree with this point. Hence, with an objective to know the importance of Sattva Sartha in prognosis of female breast cancer with relation to blood indices was carried out in 60 patients. They are the age of 30 to 70 years. And the parameters what he has looked about are HBTLC, platelets, blood urea, serum creatinine, SGOT and total bilirubin were observed for three consecutive follow-ups. On the basis of that, the data were obtained. It was observed. I will just say the conclusion of the paper is that the Pravar Sattva Sara female showed good response to the treatment with minimal changes in their blood enzymes. So he has studied the Sattva Sara responses in breast cancer patients individuals. Next, the study done on Rakta Sarata is research done by Ghate Umesh et al. He has showed the association of blood indices with Dhatu Sarata, and he has observed that Rakta Sar individual showed significant correlation with MCSC, MCH, CI and MCV, whereas a positive correlation of MCSC is seen with highest correlation values. The link has been given. You can see the paper. Next, study done by Gunawat et al. In 2015, he has studied the gender-wise distribution of Dhatu Sartha and he has observed that hematological parameters in each Dhatu Sartha are higher in males as compared to females, which suggests the strength in males is more as compared to females. He has studied the variation of hematological parameters in different Dhatu Sartha, but chiefly, he has found that the hematological parameters that he has considered were higher in males as compared to females. बल एंड धातु सर, इन अनदर स्टडी डन बाय जागृति चापले एट ऑल ही इन दिस स्टडी इंडिकेट द रेलिवेंस ऑफ बल एंड धातु सारता इन एन इंडिविजुअल. द पर्सन विद उत्तम सार आर एक्सेलेंट विद गुड फिजिकल एफिशिएंसी इंडेक्स, वाइल मध्यम सार हैव लो एवरेज फिजिकल एफिशिएंसी इंडेक्स एंड हीन सार इज ऑल्सो एसोसिएटेड विद पुअर फिजिकल एफिशिएंसी इंडेक्स. नेक्स्ट स्टडी इज डन ऑन अस्थि सार, दिस इज डन बाय घाटे एट ऑल. इन दिस स्टडी हैज रिवील्ड दैट इंडिविजुअल विद मोर परसेंटेज ऑफ अस्थि सारता हैज एफिशियंट बोन मिनरल डेंसिटी. ही हैज टेकन 50 मेल्स हेल्दी मेल्स इन हिज स्टडी 25 to 30 ईयर्स एंड सार परीक्षण वॉज डन बाय सॉफ्टवेयर दैट इज आयो सॉफ्ट सीडैक पुणे. इन दैट ही हैज असेस्ड द सारता एंड फाउंड दैट द मोर परसेंटेज ऑफ अस्थि सारता हैव एफिशियंट बोन मिनरल डेंसिटी. So these are the some studies that have been done on different SAR, but yet we have to evaluate or rather come to for a good scientific approach for assessment of SARDA, because this is an important tool for assessment of strength of an individual as it reveals the status of dhatu and sattva of an individual. By examining the SAR of an individual, we are examining the physical as well as the psychological status also of an individual, the strength. That is, we are examining the strength both in the physical as well as the psychological aspect. So, this determines the strength, the stamina of the individual, or rather we can say the bal. So, it plays a very important role while treating the patient. Hence, the significance of SAR is important while analyzing the bulk of the patient so that accordingly the treatment modalities could be administered. Until and unless we don't know the Prakriti, Agni, SAR, cost of an individual, either in a disease or in a healthy state, we cannot assess him fully, the strength. And SAR is important because it deals with the physical as well as the psychological aspect of an individual. Hence, it is important in both the states. So, it also depicts the quality of the tissue which is necessary for maintaining health and maintaining the homeostasis as well as for the prevention of disease of an individual. Thank you.